With me this morning here in the studio from H&T, I'm joined by John Nichols. John, good morning.
Good morning to you.
Results this morning are strong and a busy year for you, John. Just give us a quick overview.
It has been a very busy year. Of course, we're really pleased with the results. But that's not my results. That's all our people that work so jolly hard during the year. We made those two acquisitions, which I referred to earlier. And certainly our staff had to make a huge effort to take on board the new challenges. The integration is going really, really well. And that's partly why we've got such good results, because everybody really pulled together and just got on with bringing everybody together.
So what are you up to now? About 70 new stores, are you?
Yeah, we've got 70 odd new stores. We've got 252 around the UK. And that gives us a pretty good spread. But obviously it's the digital draw now to get people via the web into our stores, both the retail and the lending products. So still a lot to do and a lot to go for.
And so seeing good growth in the pawnbroking.
Yeah, here. I mean, we had double-digit growth on our organic business, as well as taking on board the new business that we acquired during the year.
And how's the personal loan product?
Personal loans are fine. I think, as we said at our last visit, we're not lending in the high-cost short-term credit space because the FCA had some concerns about our affordability. I'm not saying we actually agree with that, but that has yet to be determined. But what I have said is we're not going back in to that space until we and the FCA are absolutely happy with our processes. Because who would? That yet has to be determined, and that could take the rest of this year.
Give us some more detail on how retail's going.
Retail was great last year. Second half of the year, we managed to improve our margins as well as our sales. But coming into this year, it's tough. You know, it's trying to get like-for-like improvement is a struggle, but we're getting it, but only just.
What about concerns with coronavirus and perhaps people not heading out to stores?
That is a problem that is facing the country. I mean, for us, we've had to dust off our disaster recovery plans and get them current to make sure that we can operate properly. Because remember that people rely upon us on the high street for their lending. We've got their goods. So we've got to make sure that we can operate wherever we can and however we can, given the current environment.
But you'd be hoping this would in turn drive traffic to the website.
I think it will drive traffic to the web. I think, you know, providing, and we've got good advice, of course, from the government as to how we should deal with basic hygiene. And, you know, that is what we can do. But if we get isolated cases and we have to isolate stores, then we have to look at how we deal with that and how we communicate with customers. But all those plans are ready should we need to put them in place.
And some of your new products like foreign currency, they're going well?
FX is going well, but of course, as we speak, very few people are traveling. So as you would imagine, but we've certainly secured supply chain in case of emergencies, if you like. So that's one of the issues you have is to make sure you've got everything, that the logistics of your supply is still in place. But yeah, it's all in good shape.
And so tell me more then, the new year itself, how's it started?
Very good. I think we're still seeing our growth in our pawnbroking activity. Retail is doing well. We've launched a new website for S1897, which has only been live for a couple of weeks now. So it's too early to say, but I'm really hopeful of some great results there. It's good. FX a little bit slack, but hey, you know, that's going to happen for the next couple of months or so.
But you must be buoyed by the strong gold price.
Strong gold price is always in our favour. We never know what we don't know, but I suspect that will continue at those rates for a while yet.
What's the plan for the year ahead?
Year ahead, do more of what we do well, and that's pawnbroking. We've got some fantastic teams now with the acquisitions, and they've really taken to heart the H&T sort of values, and it's really a good place to be.
Scope for more acquisitions?
I'm not saying there'll be more acquisitions. We'll certainly look at opportunities as they present themselves. And I think there are other things we can do for our business, which may mean acquisitions, but not necessarily on the high street.
Right, such as?
Well, there's a lot of support functions we need. You know, the bigger we get in terms of retail, the bigger we get in terms of having to supply that retail, there are other things we need, A, in the supply chain, but B, in terms of preparing goods for sale.
So you're pleased here with the numbers, the business performance. What's your view on the share price?
Well, after Black Monday, as they're now calling it. I do love the way they name these events. It's certainly undervalued in my view, but I would say that, wouldn't I? I think, you know, we've always, over the last 10, 12 years, we do what we do, you know, and eventually results will out and results will show what we're going to continue to do. So let's just wait and see.
John, always good to see you.
Thank you.